Hey guys, welcome to DIY Crafts. In this video, I'll show you how to crochet a curlicue. This can be used as a garland to idols, appliques to baby dresses and handbags. So, let's get started. For this, I'm using a 4-ply yarn and a 4mm hook. You can take any yarn and its suitable hook size. Let's begin with chain. I'm making a foundation chain of 61 stitches. You can make it according to your requirement. Now let's begin making row 1. For this, skip the first stitch from the hook and make 2 single stitches in the next stitch. That is an SC increase. That is 2 single stitches going into the same stitch. So continue this increases in each and every stitch throughout the chain until you reach the last stitch. This increases helps us to form the first line of curlicue. You can see the texture, how it is turning out. It's slowly taking a small curve. So once it is done, I'll show you how it looks like. Keep working single stitch increase until you reach the last stitch. Now we are at the end of the row 1. Make the last few increases left. And this completes first row of our curlicue. By the end of the first row, we'll have 120 stitches. You can now see how the curls has formed. Now adjust the curls as shown. Just twist them in circles so the curls takes its place. This forms the first row of curlicue. Moving on to the second row, you can continue with the same color or a different color. In this tutorial, I am adding a light orange color for second row. Change the color as shown. Now for row 2, chain 1 and turn your work. Now make 2 single stitches in each stitch. That is, continue to make a single stitch increase in each and every stitches. These increases helps to define the curls even more. That means our curlicue will look even more beautiful. Continue to make single stitch increases throughout the row until you reach the last stitch. Now we have reached the last few stitches. Make those increases in each and every stitch. So by the end of row 2, you should have 240 stitches. This completes row 2. You can see this curlicue now. It's the same process of turning the curls and making them to take its position. You don't need to adjust the curls for each and every row. We can adjust them at the last after making all the required rows. So until then, just leave it like that and continue working row 3. For row 3, I'm changing its color to deep orange. So just attach the orange as shown. Now let's start making row 3. For this, make chain 1 and turn your work. Now make 2 single stitches in each and every stitch, just like in the second row. The third row helps to make the curls look closer and a bigger one. So make single stitch increases in each and every stitch until you reach the last stitch. We have almost reached the end of the third row. So by the end of the third row, you should have 480 stitches. Now make chain 1 and fasten off the excess thread. Trim the threads by leaving a long ends, and these ends helps us to attach the curly Q to handbags or dresses. Trim the other color threads as well by leaving a long tail. You can stop it at row 3, or you can add the 4th row of single stitch increase if needed. Now it's time to shape the curly Q. For this, start from one of the ends and start twisting and turn the work in clockwise direction throughout the curly Q and make the curls to take its place. This is so satisfying to watch and make as well. Just continue to twist and turn, and you can see the curls taking its place nicely. This completes the crochet curly Q garland. You can see how the curls are nicely defined and arranged. It's now ready to decorate the idols. Do give it a try and let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. See you all in the next video. Thank you for watching. Please like the video, share it, and subscribe to DIY Crafts.